Everybody, I'm Mark Walters. Thanks again for coming out. I want to introduce you. This is Britton Peel from the Dallas Morning News. He is going to moderate this panel for you. This is his first time to ever do one of these. So be gentle. So I'm going to hand it over to Britton. He'll take it from here. Everybody enjoy what I'm sure is going to be an awesome panel.
All right. Well, I hope you guys have been enjoying FanDays so far. How's it been? It's still kind of early, but good FanDays. Well, you're not here to see me. You probably recognize this guy. If you've been watching The Flash, he was on this week's episode of The Flash. He's been on it before. He's been on The Tomorrow Children. He's been on lots of other things. Give it up for Robbie Amell. About the fans. So we're going to take questions at the microphones. They're kind of on either side of the room. So be thinking about what you might want to ask and line up shortly, but I'm selfish. I'm going to ask you some questions of my
own. Lay it on me first.
So yeah, it's lucky that we have you this week because you were just back on The Flash.
If you haven't seen the episode, close your ears.
we won't spoil it for anybody because they have all their DVRs. I mean, they've been teasing for a while that we're going to go to Earth 2 and see a very different version of your character. What was it like? I mean, you hadn't been away from the show that long.
No. I think the producers bring me back so often because I email them repeatedly. Every time they kill me, I'm like, so wouldn't it be cool if this happened?
Could I die again another way?
Yeah, exactly. But it was awesome. Danielle. I had been waiting for Danielle to be Killer Frost for a long time because she was so excited to do it, and I just lucked out in getting to be a part of it and being, you know, the other half of our Bonnie and Clyde type team. But it was super cool. I got there a little early so they could fit me with an actual almost costume. I finally got, you know, when you're a bad guy, you have to wear a leather jacket. So I got my leather jacket with my splicer. I just happened to have longer hair at the time, so they kept it so that it was just a different look. But it was really fun, you know. When you're playing a villain, you get to kind of, you just get to act a little bigger and have a little more fun with it. And it's almost like wearing a pair of sunglasses. You have a little bit more confidence because you don't see yourself looking too goofy.
Sure, yeah, definitely look a lot cooler. So I mean, you don't get that kind of opportunity very often, though, to play kind of the same character, but such a different take. Was it hard finding exactly how to twist the character to be villainous instead of so good?
That was kind of the nice thing, and it's always been the nice thing about working with good writers, is they just put the words on the page for you, and you just try not to screw it up. And getting to work, you know, opposite Danielle and alongside, you know, the different versions of everybody with reverb and having to get into work with Zoom. I'm such a huge Zoom fan. I didn't know he was actually coming into the scene when we were shooting one part of it, because I hadn't seen him on set yet and I had never seen him. And at one part they could just go, "And Zoom!" And I'm like, and he just comes running in, and I can't tell you anything about him because I would be like sniped by somebody. But I was so blown away. I just think it's such a cool villain. And getting to see him in person was like a total fanboy moment for me. And the cameras just happened to be rolling.
So is that almost like a celebrity moment for you?
Oh, for sure. I still geek out. I mean, getting to be a part of it is you know, Stephen always says, when people are like, it's your childhood dream come true, it being in wrestling, and he's like, no, that's my dream, not my childhood dream. He's right, you know, I still have a lot of the same dreams I did when I was a kid, and I get to live them out on The Flash.
Awesome. Well, Flash is the only thing you got going on right now. In, what, a couple of days, you're going to make your debut on the X-Files.
Yes. I haven't seen it yet, I hope it's good. I mean, I trust them. I was there. Everything was awesome. But you know, you never want to be a character of such an iconic show that people don't like. So there's a little bit of pressure with Monday night coming up. I know the episode leaked for like 3 hours last night on Hulu. A lot of people were talking about it. Sounds like the episode's really great. I haven't seen it because they're super secretive, and I probably could have seen it if I was in LA, but I'm shooting a movie in Toronto, which is why I was a little late this morning. I'm sorry. It's negative 41 there. But I haven't seen the episode, so I'm in the same boat as everybody else here who's a fan of the show. I think the first four episodes were awesome. Second episode was my favorite. There was like a cool X-Men type moment at the end of the episode. But I hope it's good. I think it's going to be good.
I hope it's good too, for your sake.
I know the finale is massive. I won't tell you anything about it, but the finale, I'll warn you, has the biggest cliffhanger I've ever seen on television.
And we've been working with Laura Ambrose as kind of your counterpart, and people have been calling you, even based on just the clips that have not leaked but have actually been released. You've been kind of compared to a younger Mulder and Scully. Is that
so? That was the idea. There was Chris wanted there to be a little bit of a comedic element behind it. Of one of the first scenes is Lauren's character, Agent Einstein, and myself meeting Mulder and Scully in the X-Files office. And there's that moment where she's looking at me and looking at Lauren, and she's just going, really, this is, you're a medical doctor, you're obsessed with the paranormal. And we're not supposed to be the new version of them by any means. I mean, the show is really David and Jillian's. It's Mulder and Scully, and that's what the fans want. And being on set, watching them work, I understand why the show is like as iconic as it is, but getting to be a part of it was awesome, and hopefully they don't kill me as much as they do on Flash.
So you and I are about the same age, and I know that when X-Files was on, my dad would watch it after I went to bed.
Oh, he scared the crap out of me.
He would sleep with a bat next to the sofa because he'd fall asleep on the couch because he was terrified. So I wasn't allowed to watch it. Did you kind of grow up watching it?
Nope. I remember trying to watch a few episodes. I was like, no way. When I was up for the role, I watched a couple episodes, and then when I booked it, I did the silly thing of like Google top 10 X-Files episodes. So I was like, I can't watch 10 seasons before we start shooting. And I started with the pilot, and I hadn't seen the pilot. I don't know if I had ever seen the pilot. I probably did when I was young, but I didn't remember it. And I hadn't seen the pilot since I had, started in the industry and recognized what goes into making a TV episode and how things progress over the years. And it still holds up, which is really incredible. The pilot was done in like 94 or something, maybe something like that. And it's still a good episode of TV, which is rare. You know, a lot of things just can't hold up with time. And from there, I went through a few. There's an episode called Home that got banned from television for a while. If you haven't seen it, just don't watch it. You won't sleep for a while. It was great. It actually kind of worked out. Top 10 episodes are all really good episodes of TV.
Awesome. I think we'll get to fan questions in just 1 second, but I cover a lot of video game stuff, so I was trolling your Twitter account earlier and saw that you're kind of a gamer yourself.
I am.
So I just want to ask, what are you into? What do you play when you're not filming stuff?
I got heavily into Destiny for a while. It was so many hours on Destiny. I haven't been gaming much lately because I was in Vancouver for Flash and X-Files, and then I was doing a movie in L.A., and then I flew to Toronto to see family. I got back to LA and booked another movie, and I've been in Toronto. And it's tough to bring my Xbox with me if I know I'm working, because it's just such a it's just such a bad idea because I won't work.
It seems like it'd be frowned upon.
Yeah. So I haven't yet. There's a game called Division that all my buddies are playing. They loved it. So I'm pumped to get into that. But I think the beta's finished. So.
Very cool.
So I missed it. I'll get it when it comes out.
Awesome. All right, well, let's start with some fan questions. Let's start over here on this side of the room.
My name's Trevor. Do you watch scary movies or play scary video games?
I used to love the Resident Evil games. Back when they would really scare me when you're like walking through a slow hallway and the music and then the dogs would jump through the window. I do like scary movies. What's the most recent? What scary movie have I seen? What came out lately? I don't think I've seen a horror movie in a little while, but I do like them. I go see them whenever they come out. The Conjuring was a long time ago, but the trailer for the second one looks pretty terrifying. But I can't remember the last scary movie I saw. My fiance, when we go see a scary movie, we'll watch them like this. And she claims that if she can't hear them, she won't get startled, and she closes her eyes just enough to see little movements. And I'm like, why even watch the movie then? But I can't remember the last one I went to. Thanks, buddy.
Yeah,
you.
Let's go to the other side.
Hi, I just want to ask you about Flash. So when you died at the end of the season finale, did you go to Ryan go to Earth 2, or did you go to X-Files Earth?
I went to X-Files. I think that was pretty much it. The main thing behind that was the timing didn't work out for me for Legends of Tomorrow to shoot it, and Firestorm had to be a part of that show, and it couldn't be me, so the idea was I had to die, you had to introduce a new Firestorm, and then they just kept getting annoying emails from me asking when I was going to be brought back, so I'm just going to see how long that works.
How many other Earths do we have that we can bring back?
So many. Plus, you know, Ronnie is, I truly believe that Ronnie from Earth 1 is dead. I think you can only sacrifice yourself so many times without actually dying before people are like, oh, here we go. But I would always love to go back to that show. I love the cast. I love the producers. A lot of the same crew that worked on the Tomorrow People, because it shoots in Vancouver. It's that show will always have a place very close to my heart, and I'll go back anytime they want me to.
Awesome. And we'll go back over here.
Okay, so whenever you're on the set of The Flash, who's your favorite actor or actress to work with?
Danielle's not here, so you don't have to say her, right?
No, a lot of them for different reasons. I love working with Danielle. She's as sweet as you would think she is. She's just a very wonderful girl. Grant is a lot of fun, plus then you're doing scenes with The Flash, which is super cool. Getting to work with my cousin was it's so rare to get to, you know, work alongside family, especially when you're doing something you love. And Victor Garber I was a huge fan of his. We had done a little TV movie together, maybe a year prior. And when he got cast, I was really excited to work with him. He's incredibly sarcastic and witty, and everybody on that set is a lot of fun. Can't really go wrong. Thanks.
Next person over here.
When you got the role as Firestorm, did you do any research behind it to figure out if there was any past things in a way that would influence your role?
Yeah, I was shooting a movie called Max in Charlotte. I get a phone call from Greg Berlanti, and he was like, this was shortly after Tomorrow People had been canceled, and he was like, I want to start by saying I'm sorry again, and I have a role for you on The Flash if you want to come do it. And I was like, yeah, cool, what is it? And he told me Firestorm, and I honestly didn't know who he was. So I was like, great, I don't know who he is, but I'm in. And a week later, I arrived in Toronto to see family, and there was a care package waiting from DC, and it was full of comics that had Firestorm in it. Some Justice League stuff, some Firestorm standalone, and a couple Firestorm action figures. And that was just kind of a cool special moment to open a care package from a company that has, you know, given me so much joy throughout my life, so I just dove right back in.
Thanks. Do you find yourself reading more comics now that you've been in the show?
I find myself watching more. There's just so much good comics. There are so many good comics made into TV and movies that it's such a bad example to be like, I don't read anymore. I watch television and movies.
Kids, I know.
But the problem is I spend so much time reading scripts and learning lines that it's nice to just to be able to escape and enjoy, you know, sitting back and watching it on TV. I went and saw Deadpool on Thursday. And don't take your kids to Deadpool on Thursday. But if you haven't seen it, just leave. Just go see it immediately. It's so good.
Awesome. Another question over here.
Hi, my name's Tristan.
Hey.
And I was wondering, is there a chance that the Tomorrow People could return, like a reunion or as another season?
God, that'd be awesome. I don't think anytime soon. I think the best case scenario is kind of like what they did with Veronica Mars, where it's tough because we only did one season. You know, that show did several seasons, and then they were able to Indiegogo or kickstart a campaign to get in a movie. But I think other than that, it would be really tough to get it going again. You take a big swing making a TV show, and if it doesn't work, it's really tough to get another shot at it. The sad thing is, you know, if you look at ratings and stuff, where our numbers when we were canceled would be a hit on the CW this year. So it's one of those things where there are factors that go into it, and you need a lot of luck. So I'm really thankful to have gotten a full season out of it, and I had a ton of fun making it, and I made a lot of friends and fans, and it got me my next job, which was Firestorm, so I can't complain, but it would be really cool to even make like a movie or something. It would be really fun.
Yeah. Thanks, bud. Awesome. Do we have another question over here?
What's the best question you've ever been asked?
That one. There was a question. Stephen and I were doing a Q&A on his Facebook page, and somebody asked, I'm going to butcher this because I can't remember what it was. It was, if you could have, like, arm-sized fingers or finger-sized arms. It was something so weird. I'm definitely butchering it, but it was a super weird out there question, and it struck me as being a fun, weird question to answer.
Do you remember what your answer was?
No, because I don't even remember the question.
Alright, thanks.
If you've seen the Marvel Netflix shows Daredevil and Jessica Jones, how do you think they compare to Flash?
They're definitely different. I think I like them. I enjoy them. I'm working with Rachel Taylor, who's on Jessica Jones. And she had a blast doing it and had nothing but great things to say. I think Flash is a little more fun. That's not to say it's better or worse. I just think it's a little easier to watch and let yourself have a good time watching it. Daredevil's very dark. Jessica Jones is very dark. But it's all personal preference, you know? It's kind of like the Marvel-DC thing, even though it's the opposite in this case. You know, for a long time, a lot of the DC movies were super dark, and the Marvel ones were very light. And I think there are good versions of both, and I think we're at a really lucky time right now in TV and film for comic books where there are good versions of both. You know, I really enjoyed Daredevil and Jessica Jones, and they're both dark, but I do love The Flash, and it's just a little more fun. Thanks.
Next question.
Hi.
Hi.
I've been a huge fan for a very long time, since I was younger, and I was wondering, like, what's kind of the first thing you think of when you're asked about, like, when you were in Scooby-Doo or True Jackson?
I've had a lot of fun in my career, and True Jackson, we did live tapings every Friday night, and that was, I mean, I did around 40 episodes, which meant 40 Fridays of live tapings in front of, like, an audience of approximately this size. We would do the show for 3 hours, and not only was it at a time in my career where I really needed the experience and to learn what I was doing, and I got to learn from a lot of great people, it was so much fun. It was, you know, a lot of people in the business will say that a half-hour comedy, like a sitcom, is the best job in the business, and they're not wrong. It is so much fun to just rehearse, you know, 3 or 4 days a week, and then put on a show for, you know, for 300 or 400 people, and it's almost like it combines theater and television, and it's just a thrill. It's very fun, and there's just no other feeling like it.
Is that a format that you would go back to?
I love doing comedy. I really enjoy it. You learn that there's formula, you know, there's a formula to it, and I would love to do more and more comedy, but I like doing a little bit of everything, which is kind of nice about, you know, not having a contract on The Flash, just being able to go back for an episode or two before they kill me, and then being able to do The X-Files, and then, you know, last year I did The X-Files, Flash, I did a movie where I play a murderer, I did a movie where I play Kevin Spacey's son, where he turned into a cat. Like, I did just the weirdest things, but it was really fun, and I enjoyed all of them for different reasons.
Awesome. Who is your favorite Justice League member besides The Flash?
Why isn't it The Flash?
Because it can't be The Flash.
It wouldn't be The Flash. I'm just a massive Batman fan. Just anything Batman, Nightwing, Batman, Batman Beyond. I'm just a huge, huge, huge Batman fan.
Cool. That was an easy one, sounds like.
Yeah.
Next question.
So I was wondering whether Stephen gives you Alicity spoilers to tease your fiance. Yeah.
He wouldn't dare. I was sitting in, this is a while ago, so if I spoil this for you, it's your own fault. Before Oliver's mom died on the show, I was sitting in a car, and who was it? Manu Bennett was like, blah, 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 he's talking, and he's like, yeah, and then they kill her, and I was like, and Steven just goes, we don't give Robbie spoilers. And he's like, oh, sorry. Continue, Manu. So no, Steven knows no spoilers. Thanks.
You keep mentioning a movie in Toronto. Can you talk more about what you're working on and what your favorite movie's been so far this year?
Sure. Just this year, like from January on? Because it's Deadpool. That's it. I'm doing a movie for Netflix called Arc. If you saw Edge of Tomorrow, the Tom Cruise movie, it's got a similar time loop sort of thing. I'm living the same 3 hours over and over again, and I keep getting killed. It's kind of like being on The Flash. But it's super cool. It's a Canadian writer-director, myself and Rachel Taylor are the two leads, and I can't give you too much about it because I just don't know what I'm allowed to say, but it will be on Netflix probably towards the end of this year, and it's called Arc, A-R-Q, and I'm really excited about it. It's a really fun movie, which is why I look homeless. They shaved my head and made me grow out my awful facial hair. As far as movies go, last year my favorite movies were Creed, Ex Machina, I'm sure there are more, but that's what's coming to mind at the moment.
Cool. Thanks.
Thank you.
Alright, I was wondering who you would think would win in a battle, The Flash or The Arrow?
Choose your loyalties carefully.
You'd never get a winner. They'd never allow it. One of them is extremely, extremely powerful, and the other has a bow and arrow. I can't really say that because Batman's my favorite superhero. So if you're like, if Batman, like, and I'm like, Batman's just a rich guy. Arrow would probably win. I'm a huge Batman fan. I think Batman would destroy Superman because kryptonite. Which is super boring, but you have a huge weakness.
And don't make yourself so vulnerable.
Yeah.
Next time you crash from another planet.
Thank you.
Next question.
What's it like seeing people react to your death on The Flash?
So good. It's actually so fun. I wasn't able to watch the episode live on Monday or Tuesday because I was in Toronto shooting. And I just kept checking my Twitter. I'm like, what time is it? When do I die? And I'm like, and right about now, when I look at it, it's like, God, what the hell? No! I knew it! People were seriously angry this time.
As the years go on, when that question's asked, we're gonna have to ask which time.
Yeah, so we'll
Thank you. Come back over here.
Hi, my name is Cooper, and how many more episodes to Phantom at the Zoomies, and is it any gone?
I missed the end of that one.
He's really right at the beginning.
I'm gonna be 100% honest with you. I don't know who it is, I swear to God. I'm not just like saying that. I don't know who it is because I haven't spent enough time there. I will tell you that a lot of what's done in the Zoom suit is a stuntman. I'm not lying to you, I haven't met the real Zoom. I've met the big Australian dude that's in the Zoom suit.
Did you rip off the mask? Like, ah!
No, I was too starstruck. I'm like, whoa! Zoom! I took a picture with him. I did a selfie with Zoom. In the Firestorm outfit. Death Storm outfit.
Yeah, very good.
Hi, I'm Samia, big fan.
Thanks.
So I was wondering, are you and Italia gonna make any future appearances on a TV show or a movie together?
Italia's shooting Supergirl right now. I wish I could tell you more, but I would be in a lot of trouble. All I can tell you is what was announced. She's playing Silver Banshee on Supergirl. She's got a big arc. She's having a blast doing it. She had 5 hours of makeup yesterday morning to become Banshee, and it looks awesome. Shooting with her would be incredible. But she also just booked a TV show shooting in Toronto with Kiefer Sutherland. Called Designated Survivor, where he becomes the president. So I don't think we'll be shooting any Firestorm Banshee scenes anytime soon. I think my best opportunity would be to find my way into the White House.
Did Earth One Ronnie fall into Supergirl?
He's just Supergirl. That'd be a cool place to find him. I thought you were gonna say the White House. He's just like working as a correspondent.
No, that's the after X-Files, then he falls.
That's right.
Yeah. Thanks. Next question.
If you could shoot a film with anybody in the world, who would it be and why?
Tom Cruise. I'm a huge Tom Cruise fan. On my way here, I watched Jerry Maguire. I'm just a big, huge fan of his. I've loved his movies since I was a kid. There are plenty of actors I'd love to work with, but that's just the name at the top of the list. Thank you.
Hi.
Hi.
What's the biggest argument that you and Steven have gotten into?
And who won?
We don't argue about things together. We argue about things with other people about each other. Like who's older, which is not an argument. There's just facts here. He was born in 1981, and I was born in 1988. He's significantly older than me.
So you won that one, I guess. I hope. I guess
not really.
Show me the birth certificate. Thanks. Next question over here.
Hi, I wanted to know what one of your more like embarrassing or maybe funny moments were on set.
I'm very hard to embarrass. I just laugh at things when I get embarrassed. But I mean, there are plenty of times that you screw up lines or can't remember things, or you're on a set that costs a whole lot of money with people who are, you know, there's a lot of things to do. Time is very expensive when you're on a set. So when you start screwing up, you start getting the giggles, because it's like, anytime you're not allowed to laugh, it just makes everything that much funnier. So it's not so much embarrassing as it's just really, really funny. When you start screwing up and you start losing it, like, everybody will have to walk away for a few minutes occasionally. And then you come back and there's way more pressure and you end up laughing again. There was one time, and it was pretty early on, it wasn't me, it was Danielle, so I'm throwing her under the bus. Victor Garp, we were doing a scene with Victor, myself, and Danielle, and Victor screwed up one of his lines, but he said it in a really funny way. It was one of those, like, why is Ronald still inside me, or something like that. And he said somebody's name. He was like, oh, he was looking at Danielle, so he said, I'm still inside Daniel. And all you hear is Grant go, who's Daniel? And Danielle and I could not keep it together, to the point where Victor's here talking this way and Danielle had to turn her back to him, and she's just shaking because she's laughing so hard. So it wasn't really embarrassing as much as it was just like funny and a little embarrassing.
Hi, my name's Lauren. Who's your favorite villain from Batman?
Whew. Arnold Schwarzenegger. I don't know. I'm a huge, huge, huge fan of the Joker, just in general. I'm pretty excited about the new one, in Suicide Squad. I actually think he'll do a good job. He's a really talented actor. Nobody was gonna have a good time filling those shoes. But then again, you know, everybody was against Heath Ledger taking the role in the first place, so. I'm excited for that. I'd like to see a good Catwoman. I think it's been a little while. Or forever, depending on who you ask. Yeah, the original. It was okay. Or Returns. Halle Berry's was just a little odd looking. Yeah, Pfeiffer was hot as Catwoman. That was cool. I don't know. I've enjoyed most of the villains in the movies. I mean, the Penguin was super weird and fun and cool. Joker was great. The Riddler wasn't the best, but it wasn't terrible. I mean, just anything but Arnold. Thank you.
Thanks. We've still got a little bit of time where we're going to be wrapping up in the nearest future, so. Question. What's your advice for those who are going in the field of acting or film, and how did you start?
I did commercials and stuff when I was really young. My mom got me into it, honestly, just to as a way to start like a little college fund. My sister and I both did it, just on occasion, not a whole lot of work. And I just got super lucky. My commercial agent happened to get a breakdown for Cheaper by the Dozen 2, and they were looking for somebody that looked like they could be Eugene Levy's son, and I had the right hair color, and I was the right age, and it just worked out, and that was the little, you know, the little opening that I needed, and I got a new agent and tried to pursue it. But the best advice I could give, there's a few things. Never pay any money unless you're making money. No agent will ever ask for money from you. They take a commission off of what you're making. If somebody asks for money, just run. They're scamming you or they're just bad at their job. There will be a ton of rejection. That's just the way it works. You know, biggest actors on the planet still don't get every movie they want. It's just the way it goes. You will not book every job you go out for. You can't take it personally. For a long time, when I didn't get jobs and they were like, you were great, you just weren't the guy, I was like, what does that mean? You know, let me try and be the guy. And then I was on the other side of the casting process and I read with other people. And there are certain roles that you're just innately not that person. And I know it sounds weird, but that carries a lot of weight when you're seeing, you know, tens, twenties, hundreds of people for certain jobs. Some people are just right for the role and you aren't. That's most of the advice I can give you. Other than that, if you're ever not enjoying it, stop doing it. You know, if it's a dream, that's awesome. I think everybody should try and pursue their dreams, but if it ever gets to a point where you're not enjoying trying to do it, then find something that you enjoy and do that. Also, if you want an agent, just, you know, we're living in such a great time with the video quality on phones, and just go out and shoot something with some friends, and, you know, shoot some scenes, shoot a monologue, use that to get your foot in the door at an open casting for an agency.
Good luck.
Mm-hmm. Next question.
I'm Guy, and what's your favorite thing about acting?
That they pay me to do it. No, it's that I get to enjoy going to work. And I think everybody should at least enjoy what they do. And if you're gonna spend that much of your life doing something, then like it. And I love it. Trying to find the next job is always terrifying because you never know when it's gonna come or what it's gonna be. And you know that they're, you know, you'll work yourself up, you'll get an audition, you'll think this is the one, and you'll want it so bad, and it's just not the one. So that side of the industry sucks, and there's nothing you can do about it, but when it is the one that you really want and you book it, that outweighs the bad by a mile. Thanks.
Hello. Hey. What's the craziest or, like, funniest experience you've had with a fan, like, in person?
There was a weird one. What was it? I was at a con and somebody had a sign and I can't remember what the sign was. Oh man. I haven't had that many weird experiences. Everybody's super cool. I mean, the nice thing about going to these cons is, you know, if you're not coming into this room unless you want to be here. And it's the best energy, you know, the best fans in the world. And it's fun to get to hang out with you guys and talk about what's going on. And things don't normally get that weird. I'm sure there are some moments that I'm forgetting, but I haven't had anything super weird or creepy or anything yet.
Yeah.
It's only Saturday.
I know we have lots of people still lining up. We probably have time for like two, maybe three more. So you can come back over here.
Hi, I'm
Lindsay.
Hi. You've died so many times on The Flash. Now when you get a role and you have to die, are you like, hold on, I gotta prepare? You're like, no guys, I got this.
Oh, I got this. Especially since the thing I'm shooting right now, the first day of shooting was all of my... Because if you've seen Edge of Tomorrow, when you die, he wakes up, like it's a time loop. So day one was like 8 different wake-ups just after being killed, and I'm like, oh yeah, we're good. Been doing this all year. But no, I mean, it's always weird. Dying is tough, because if you have a bad death, there's nothing worse than that. You want a memorable death.
Thanks. You get lots of chances.
Yeah.
Hi, my name is Ian, and what is your favorite thing besides making shows and movies?
I love hockey. I'm a big hockey fan. I grew up playing it. I still play it in a little men's league in Burbank. Golf, big golfer, going to movies, playing video games, I like Dave and Buster style places, try and win all those tickets, that sort of, I'm a giant child is what I'm pretty much, trying to tell you. I really love my job, but getting to make movies with friends is kind of that would be the top. So keep your eyes out on March 22nd on mine and Steven's Facebook page. We've been trying to do something for a long time together, and we're gonna launch something big. Yeah, it's gonna be huge. I promise you guys will be blown away. It's gonna be really cool.
Awesome. Before the next question, can I just say, go Stars?
No. Actually, I like the Stars. Tyler Sagan's really sick.
All right, next question.
On your, which girl would you prefer to be with, Daphne or Chewie
Jackson? Daphne or who?
Chewie Jackson.
Oh, man. I had more fun with Chewie Jackson. Kiki's hilarious. She cracks me up. Thank you.
Hi. If you could turn into one animal, like any animal, what would it be?
Cool question. Oh man. Do dinosaurs count? Yeah? Oh man. Now I'm like ocean or sky? It's not gonna be on land. I've done land. I don't need to just be faster on land. It's either gonna be like a pterodactyl or not a shark, because I don't wanna be a shark. Sharks freak me out. I have no interest in being one. Some kind of like a whale that has no predators. Whatever I'm gonna be, it's either flying or it's in the ocean and is at the absolute top of the food chain. You fill in the blanks. Thank you.
All right, let's do maybe one more. One or two.
Why do you think people want me to die so much in the movies?
Who said people want me to die in the movies? I think it's so that we, you know, they know that it'll break everybody's heart when I die. You don't kill the guy people want to die, because everybody's like, yeah, and then it's like it's done for a while. You want people to be like, oh no, not Tommy again. We just got him back. I don't know, good question.
All right, last one.
Do you watch Gotham, and what is your favorite episode?
I don't watch Gotham, but I'm excited to start it. The director of The Tomorrow People directed the pilot and a bunch of episodes of Gotham. And I really like the cast. I really like what I've seen of the show. But I have a problem doing the like week-by-week thing for, honestly, lack of time. But is it on Netflix yet?
Yeah.
Perfect. I think we have time for the last question. I don't actually know, I just said that. I have no concept of time.
It's your thing, man.
Okay, so unbiased to your role as Firestorm on The Flash, do you honestly think that Firestorm or Firefly would win in a fight?
Firestorm. How, like, short of a black hole, how are you gonna kill me? Unless you're Zoom. It's like, also, I don't know about that Zoom death, to be honest with you.
Well, I guess we'll find out.
I feel like Firestorm at his best would just destroy Zoom. Just crush him.
If only we knew.
Yeah. Thanks, guys!
Thank you all. Woo!
March 22nd, look out for it. It'll be cool, I promise.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining the panel. We will be clearing the panel room at this time.